So, hello my friends, again we are here to teach one of the important topic of engineering mathematics, that is called difference equation. Now difference equation is what? What is the difference between difference equation and differential equation? Actually a differential equation contains derivatives, and difference equation means an equation which contains difference of dependent variable. For example, if we write yk plus 2 minus yk plus 1 plus 8yk is equal to 0. So this type of equation is called difference equation. If right hand side is 0, then we call it's a homogeneous. If right hand side is non-zero, we call it is non-homogeneous difference equation. Same like a differential equation, here also solution contains two parts. If it is non-homogeneous, if it is homogeneous, then only complementary function is the solution. Now, how we write solution? I'm going to teach you easy way. So, way is just replace yk by 1, yk plus 1 by m, yk plus 2 by m square, and so on. It is very similar to differential equation, how we write auxiliary equation. So how we write auxiliary equation? If you remember, then in differential equation again we, in place of y we are putting 1, in place of dy by dx we are putting m, in place of d2y by dx square we are putting m square. Similarly here we can write characteristic equation. So how we write? Just replace yk by 1, yk plus 1 by m, yk plus 2 is by m square, and so on. Suppose yk plus 3, then m cube, and so on. So now I'm going to teach how we solve. So for example, we are taking one equation yk plus 2 minus 8yk plus 1 plus 15yk is equal to 0. Suppose this difference equation given, this is homogeneous because right hand side is 0. So how we solve? So our first step is write characteristic equation. How we write? Same, just now I told yk plus 2 means we replace by m square minus 8m plus 15 is equal to 0. As you see, one algebraic equation we have, same like a differential equation, solve it and get the roots. What are the roots? M is equal to 8 plus minus 5 and 3 are the roots. What are the possibilities? Because this is quadratic equation, so two roots are there. You know nature of roots. Nature of roots, how many types? Three types. Either it is real and unequal, real and equal, and imaginary. Already we did in differential equation based on nature of roots, how we write solution. Similarly here, case first, when roots are real and unequal. Say m is equal to lambda 1, lambda 2, and so on. In this case, solution is yk h. We denote complementary function by this way, is c1 lambda 1 to the power k plus c2 lambda 2 to the power k, where c1 and c2 are arbitrary constant and lambda 1 and lambda 2 are the roots. Sometimes we have a third degree equation, no matter if roots are real and unequal, we go by this way only. What is next one? C3 lambda 3 to the power k, and so on. So for this example, roots are real and unequal. So what is the solution if we want to write? So what is yk? Because this is homogeneous, so solution means only complementary function, so we can write yk. What is yk? C1 5 to the power k plus c2 3 to the power k, because lambda 1 is 5, lambda 2 is 3. Hope you understand. So you understand the basic steps. It's very simple thing. Just how we write characteristic equation, just replace yk by 1, yk plus 1 by m, yk plus 2 by m square, and so on. Once you replace, you will get characteristic equation, solve it. Definitely, you have different types of roots. So based on nature of roots, you can write the solution directly. Case first, when roots are real and unequal. Suppose one root is lambda 1, one root is lambda 2, second root is lambda 2, and third is lambda 3, and so on. So this is the methodology to write complementary function. Now come for second case, case 2. Case 2 means when roots are real and equal. Say m is equal to lambda 1 is equal to lambda 2. It means in this case lambda 1 is equal to lambda 2. Both roots are equal. In this case, what is the solution? It's very simple, similar to differential equation c1 plus c2k lambda to the power k. Suppose three roots are common, then lambda 1 is equal to lambda 2 is equal to lambda 3, then nothing. Same, c1 plus c2k plus c3k square. If four roots are common, then c1 plus c2k plus c3k cube plus c4 c1 plus c2k plus c3k square plus c4k cube, and in this way we can write. For example, so now, how we solve this question? Yk plus 2 minus 9yk plus 1 plus 6yk is equal to 0. First write characteristic equation. How we write? In place of yk plus 2, write m square. In place of yk plus 1, write m plus 6 is equal to 0. When you solve, what are the roots? 3, 3. So as you see, roots are real and equal to summation means C1 plus C2k. What is lambda value? 3 to the power k. So it's very simple to write solution for a homogeneous part when roots are equal. Now we are moving for third case. Third case is what? When roots are imaginary. Say m is equal to alpha plus minus iota beta. You know very well, imaginary roots always comes in pair. So if you one root is plus alpha plus iota beta, then definitely second root is alpha minus iota beta. In this case, solution is r to the power k c1 cos k theta plus c2 sin k theta, where r is modulus of this complex number. It means alpha square plus beta square. And what is theta? Argument. Argument means tan inverse beta by alpha. Hope you understand. When roots comes in imaginary form, suppose alpha plus minus iota beta, then easy, calculate modulus of complex number, that root, and argument. So you will easily know what is the value of r and what is the value of theta. Once you know r and theta, just put in this equation and you will get the solution. So it's easy. We do one question here. So in this case, what is correct is equation m square minus 2m plus 2 is equal to 0. So what is m value? 2 plus minus under root b square minus minus 4ac. By 2. So 2 plus minus 4 minus 8 means minus 4 means plus minus 2 iota by 2 means 1 plus minus iota. So now we have roots in complex form. Then how we get its modulus? So what is r value? R value is modulus of this complex number. What is alpha? 1. What is beta? 1. So alpha square plus beta square means root 2. What is theta? Tan inverse beta by alpha. What is beta? 1 by 1. It means tan inverse 1 means pi by 4. So now you have r and theta value. So just put here. So what is the solution in this case? Root 2 to the power k c1 cos k pi by 4 plus c2 sin k pi by 4. This is the answer. This is case third. Hope you understand. When roots are imaginary, what is the procedure? Very easy. Just calculate modulus and argument of complex number. Then put r and theta value here and you will get the roots. You can write again by one more method is there, and that is the roots are imaginary and unequal type. It means if one root is 1 plus iota, second root is 1 minus iota. So not only this way, you can write solution in this way also. YKh is equal to C1 1 plus iota to the power k plus C2 1 minus iota to the power k. This is also correct. But this is the better way. It's my advice. Now, actually, main case is over. But what happened? When roots are imaginary and equal. Suppose we have any fourth order equation. I will do that first. Case 4. When roots are imaginary and equal. Suppose say m is equal to alpha plus minus iota beta comma alpha plus minus iota beta. So here you see both are complex number and both are equal. This possibility comes when we have fourth order difference equation. For example, just now we did yk plus 2 minus 2 yk plus 1 plus 2 yk whole square is equal to 0. Then here we got the roots m is equal to 1 plus minus iota. So 1 plus minus iota will be repeated because here square is there. So this is the root. Then what is the solution here? Ykh, same. Roots are imaginary and equal. So r to the power k same. In place of arbitrary constant, we have to write c1 plus c2k cos k theta plus c3 plus c4k sin k theta. Hope you understand. It is similar to differential equation type case. When roots are imaginary and equal, go by this way. So for this, what is r value? Root 2. What is theta value? Pi by 4. So just put the value. So root 2 to the power k c1 plus c2k cos k pi by 4 plus c3 plus c4k sin k pi by 4. This is the answer. So my friends, hope you understand how easily we can solve difference equation when it is homogeneous. Definitely this all questions which I solved, it is homogeneous and linear homogeneous differential equation with constant coefficient. In next video I will tell how easily you can solve non-homogeneous difference equation using undetermined coefficient method. Not general method I am going to explain. I am going to explain using undetermined coefficient method to solve linear difference equation with constant coefficient. Thank you.